Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In previous class, we discussed about Muhammad al-Fatih and his most important conquest of Constantinople. Today we are going to discuss other campaigns and conquests of Muhammad al-Fatih. After the conquest of Constantinople, Muhammad al-Fatih conquered many places in Europe. So the first one is Genoese colonies in Aegean, and he conquered this place in 1455. And the major campaign after the campaign of Constantinople was the campaign against Serbia, and in that battle he conquered Serbia and annexed Serbia completely to Ottoman Empire in 1459. And also he started a campaign against Moria in 1458, and he completed that by conquering Moria in 1460. And he conquered Trebizond in 1461. And also he has to deal with the issue against Wallachia, as they refused to pay annual tribute to Ottoman Empire. So Muhammad al-Fatih sent Mahmud Pasha and he restored Wallachia into his control in 1462. In 1463, Ottoman Empire, under the leadership of Muhammad al-Fatih, conquered Bosnia and Herzegovina. And after this conquest, Pope and the Duke of Burgundy made a 3-year commitment to an anti-Ottoman crusade, because Ottomans were conquering many Christian countries under the leadership of Muhammad al-Fatih. But this crusade against Ottoman Empire was short-lived. It was ended by the end of 1464 without any good results for Christians. And after the bad end of crusade against Ottoman Empire, there started a new battle by Venetians and Persians against Ottoman Empire. But it was also suppressed by Muhammad al-Fatih in 1473. And in this time, he conquered a huge country named Anatolia, and he took approximately 10 years to conquer Anatolia completely. He started the battle against Anatolia in 1464. And he completely conquered Anatolia in 1473. And in 1474, Ottoman Empire conquered their neighbor dynasty Karaman, which was also a Muslim dynasty. And they were fighting against Ottoman Empire for a long time. And Muhammad al-Fatih conquered them completely in 1474. In 1475, Ottoman Empire attacked Crimea and captured them. And the same year, they started a campaign against Moldavia and captured Moldavia in 1476. And Ottoman Empire faced a severe trouble in the battle against Albania. That battle continued for 12 years, which was started in 1466. And it ended by capturing Albania in 1478. In short, we can say Muhammad al-Fatih wanted to conquer all over the world, and he tried his best to conquer all major dynasties and kingdoms in Europe and Asia and Africa. So he was planning to attack Italy and capture Italy and to control Italy. And he sent an army under the leadership of Ahmad Pasha, But in this time, Muhammad II died in 1481 before this army reaching the Italy. So the army returned when they heard the news about death of Muhammad al-Fatih, and they avoided the plan of attacking Italy. So these are the major campaigns of Muhammad al-Fatih, and in coming class we will discuss about main contributions of Muhammad al-Fatih for the society and for arts and architecture of Ottoman Empire. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.